So today we're out here at Dry Creek at the lower weather site. We hiked in, which was about a 40-minute hike in. We have our supplies here, so we have little tubes that we use to put our microbial leaves in. Those are all sterile. We have gloves, nitrile gloves, that we're using to make sure that we're not adding our microbiome to the plant microbiome. And then we use ethanol to clean our gloves and to clean our forceps in between sampling to make sure that we're trying to get, you know, just that individual microbiome for that individual leaf when we're sampling from particular leaves. We're also collecting leaves that will be used to understand the chemistry. So then we'll be able to connect the chemistry of the plant with the microbiome of the plant. We want to be able to characterize how they change across seasons, how they change across different plants, how they change across different subspecies that have different chemistry, and to really understand who these microbes are, what the communities look like, and how they might be impacting the plant host. And then next steps will be to build a culture collection of bacteria and fungi that are sagebrush associated, and to be able to test out how they might affect the host plant in a controlled laboratory setting. So to understand if potentially some of these microbes are contributing to drought tolerance or to the chemistry of the leaves, which can also affect herbivory and other aspects of the health of the plant.
The ecology of microbial communities living on plant leaves is a developing field, and there have been studies on other plants looking into their microbial communities and how those interact with the plant. But currently there is no research published that shows the microbial community living on sagebrush leaves or how that can interact with the plant. The sagebrush covers most of Idaho in general. So this large sagebrush steppe ecosystem that is vulnerable covers not just a large part of Idaho, but also the entire West. So it really is applicable over a large part of the United States and will be instrumental in helping us understand how the ecosystem works going forward.
I hope that this data serves as kind of a foundation of understanding and characterizing these communities, and then will lead to us being able to potentially test out in more controlled laboratory studies how these microbes are actually affecting their host, and then hopefully in the future be able to better understand how we should use our knowledge of the microbiome in management and restoration of sagebrush.